वर्चुअल क्लास ऑफ म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन ऑफ ग्रेटर मुंबई एजुकेशन डिपार्टमेंट. आई एम मिसेस अक्षता काले एंड टुडे वी विल लर्न मैथ्स. कम ऑन, वी विल बिगिन अवर चैप्टर. टुडेज सब्जेक्ट इज मैथ्स ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 4th एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज डिविजन पार्ट 1. यस डियर स्टूडेंट्स, you know how to divide the numbers, isn't it? You have learnt this in standard 3rd, and this is the symbol we use for division. Means one horizontal line here, this, and two dots, one above the line and one below the line, isn't it? This is the symbol for division. Students, we will take a quick recap of last year's portion, that is of standard 3rd, and then we will move to the today's portion, means standard 4th portion. Okay, yes, sum is there. First we will read the sum, we will then understand, and then we will go to solve. Okay, there are 25 chocolates, very favorite one, isn't it? There are 25 chocolates. Distribute them equally among 5 children. How many does each child get? Yes, here 25 chocolates are there, and we have to distribute these 25 chocolates among these 5 students. Okay, now what we have to do here? Yes, you know that we will carry out the division. Total number of chocolates divided by number of students or number of children. We will write in division form. See, I will write here 25, and you know that this is also a division symbol, correct? Here we will write 5 outside this symbol. Okay, now you know we have to use here table for 5, means 5 times table until we get 25 or less than 25. We have to say that, or we have to reset this table. Yes dear students, we will do that. 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 5 threes are 15, 5 fours are 20, 5 fives are 25. Yes, we got 5 fives are 25, isn't it? So I will write 5 up as a quotient, and I will write 25 below this 25. We are going to subtract this, then what we will get? 0. This method you know, correct? Means what is the answer here? Means here we can say that each child will get 5 chocolates, because 5 fives are 25, and total 25 chocolates are there, and only 5 children are there. Okay, now we will distribute these 25 chocolates among 5 children. Okay, yes, these 5 to this girl, this 5 to this boy, again 5, this 5, and at last only 5 remain. This we will give to the last boy, isn't it? Means each child got 5 chocolates. There are 27 marbles. Distribute them equally among 3 children. How many does each child get? Yes dear students, you know that marbles, correct? These are marbles. How many marbles are there? 27 marbles are there. And how many children are there? 3 children are there. Means we have to distribute these 27 marbles equally among 3 children. Remember dear students, division means always distribution is equal. Okay? Okay, now we will carry out our division. Here what we will divide? We will divide total number of marbles divided by total number of children. That you know, 27 total number of marbles, so 27 divided by 3. Correct? We will go for the method 27 divided by 3. Now we are going to use 3 times table for this, isn't it? So we will recite 3 table. 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6, 3 threes are 9, 3 fours are 12, 3 fives are 15, 3 sixes are 18, 3 sevens are 21, 3 eights are 24, 3 nines are 27. Yes, we got 3 nines are 27. So I will write 9 up as a quotient and 27 below this 27. Now we are going to subtract this 27 by 27. So we will get 0. Correct? Means each child will get how many marbles? 9 marbles. According to our method, each child should get 9 marbles. Correct? Now, okay, we will distribute these 27 marbles among 3 students. Yes, these 9 for this girl, these 9 marbles for this girl, and these 9 marbles for this boy. Isn't it? No marbles left. Right? Next sum. Here, if 35 flowers are divided equally among 5 children, how many does each child get? What are there here? Flowers. Okay, how many flowers are there? 35 flowers are there. And we have to divide these 35 flowers among 5 children. Okay, these are 5 children. Okay, now we will see by the method. We will carry out 35 divided by 5. Because 35 is the number of flowers and 5 is the number of children. Isn't it? We will go through the process. 35 divided by 5. Okay. Now 5 ones are 5. 5 twos are 10. 5 threes are 15. 5 fours are 20. 5 fives are 25. 5 sixes are 30. And 5 sevens are 35. 5 eights are 40. No. We will take 5 sevens are 35. Correct? 7. And we will write 35 below this 35. And when we subtract these, we will get 0. Correct? Now, according to this method, each child will get 7 flowers. Okay? Come on, we will distribute 7 flowers to each child. One child, second one, third, fourth, and this last 7 flowers to this girl. Okay? We have solved all the 3 sums of last year. Isn't it? Now here we can see one story. A story of 12 delicious apples. Yummy, isn't it? We will go through this story. Here 12 delicious apples we can see. Okay, first, there are only 2 students. See this, one boy and one girl. Okay, now we have to distribute these 12 delicious apples among these 2 students. Okay, now we will see one by one we will distribute. First one to this girl, second to this boy. Third, I am going to give this again. Fourth, here. Fifth, to the girl. Sixth, to this boy. Seventh, here. Eighth, to this boy. Ninth one, to this girl. Tenth, to this boy. 11th, to the girl. And 12th, to this boy. means each child got equal number of apples. We will count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Means this girl Mona got 6 apples. Now what about this boy? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Means this boy Raj. Raj too got 6 apples. Correct? Earlier 12 apples were there. We have distributed 12 apples between these two children. Both of them, they received 6 apples. Correct? So this we will write in the form 6 multiplied by 2. Means the Mona got 6 apples and Raj got 6 apples. So I am going to multiply by 2. Only 2 students are there, right? So how many? What is the answer? 6, 2 za 12. Total number of apples, correct? Here, again we can see here, 12 divided by 2 I will do. You know that earlier we did like this. We divided total number of objects divided by number of students. Correct? Like here, like that only. Here also I am going to divide total number of apples divided by total number of students. How much we will get? We will see. Divided by 2 is equal to 6. Isn't it? 2 6 are 12. Right? This is nothing but we can show here interrelationship between division and multiplication. For the students, okay, we will continue the story. Then you will understand. Again, 12 apples are there. Okay, here we can see 3 students. One more came. Okay, 3 students are there. Again, we are going to divide these 12 apples among them equally. Okay. See this. First one to this girl. Second to this boy. Third to this boy. Again, 3 I will divide. Here, here and here. Okay. Again, 3 I will take. 1 to this girl. 1 to this boy. And 1 more to this boy. Last 3 remain. So I will give 1 to each. Yes, dear students, we can see here this girl got 4 apples, this boy got 4 apples, and this also got 4 apples. Okay, we can write like this. How many children are there and how many apples they got? Number of apples, number of children multiplied by number of apples they got means each child got 4 apples, isn't it? So 3 child got 3 multiplied by 4 equal to 12, right? Same thing we will write in division form. You know, total number of apples divided by number of children, 12 divided by 3. What is the answer here? 3, 4 is 12, isn't it? 4 is the answer. Means when we distribute 12 delicious apples among 3 students, each child will get 4 apples. Isn't it? First we distributed among 2 children. Now we distributed same apples among 3 children. Next we will see. Again, 12 delicious apples are there. And now, we can see 4 children are there. Isn't it? 4 children. So, now we are going to distribute these 12 apples among these 4 students. Come on, we will start. 1 to this boy, 1 second one to this girl. Third to this girl and this to this boy. Okay, four apples means eight remained. Now again we will give one apple to all these four students. One to him, one to this girl, one to this girl, and last one here. How many remained? Four remained. Again we will distribute these four among these four students. Come on, take this. You also take this. You take this, and you, this is for you. Okay, now students, here we can see four students are there, and each child got three apples. Number of apples became less. See, four students multiplied by, each child got three apples. So I am multiplying this one by three. So what is the answer? 4 3 is 12. You know that. Now same in the division form, total number of apples divided by total number of students. See here, means 4 1s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 4 3s are 12. Isn't it? Means each child got 3 apples. Right? Now we will move further. Again, there are 12 delicious apples, and now we will see how many children are there. 1 2 3 4 5 6 6 children are standing for apple. They need apples in equal portion. We will see, we will distribute these 12 apples among them. Take this. This is for you. This is for you. This one is for you. You take this. This is for you. All children, means 6 children, got one apple. They are happy. But again 6 apples are there. Again we will distribute one more time. Take this. This is your second apple. This is for you. And this is for you. Take this. And this last one is for you. Yes, dear students, your number of children increased. Correct? It became 6 number. So, apples, only 2 they got. You will see, we will write in the format, means how many students are there? 6. And how many apples they got? 2 each. So 6 2s are 12. Correct? And in the division form, total number of apple divided by 6 students. So 6 1s are 6. 6 2s are 12. Means each child got 2 apples. Isn't it? This is the interrelationship between division and multiplication. Now, in the next level, what will happen? We'll see. Again, there are 12 delicious apples. Now, there are 12 students. How many students are there? 12 students are there. Yes, they are ready to accept the apple. Okay, now we will start the distribution. See, this is for first child, for second child, third child, fourth one, fifth one, sixth, seventh one, eighth, ninth one, tenth one, 11th. And 12, our apples finished. No more apples, no more child. Yes, dear students, here 12 apples were there and 12 students were there. Isn't it? So each child got one apple. We will write 12 children multiplied by 1, because each child got one apple. So 12 ones are 12. In the division format, 12, that is total number of apples divided by 12, number of students. So 12 ones are 12 means each child got one apple, right? This is the answer. Got this story? Yes, dear students. Did you like this? Okay. Now one more here. There are 20 dots. We will arrange them in different possible way. See here. We can see 20 dots. Again, here also we will study about the interrelationship between multiplication and division. In one line, there are 10 dots. This is the second line. Here also we can see 10 dots. Okay. Total 20 dots. Now, we will arrange them in different possible way. First, we will arrange them in this manner. Means in one row, we will keep 4 dots. Here 1. Then how many rows we will get, we will see. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. Means this is the first row. I arranged in first row 4 dots. Okay, this is the second. Again, I will arrange 4 dots. In third row, 4 dots. Means 3 is 12 it became. Fourth row, how many dots? 4 dots. Fifth row, how many dots? We have to put 4 dots. See, dear students, here first row, 4 dots. Second row, third row, fourth row, that is 16. And fifth row means 20 dots are there. Means 20 divided by 4, you know that 4 5s are 20. Means we got 5 rows, isn't it? When we arrange these 20 dots in 5 rows, means in one row there are 4 dots, correct? Now we will write this 4 into 5, correct? You know how to write 4 5s are 20. Now we will make one more arrangement. We will put 5 dots in one row. We will see. Okay. Now again here 5 dots we have to put in the first row. This is first row, 5 dots. Second row. Here also 5 means 10. This is third row. 15. This is the last row. This became 20 dots. First row with 5 dots, second row, third row, and fourth row. Means there are altogether 20 dots. Means when we put 5 dots in one row, we got only 4 rows. Isn't it? Here it is 32 divided by 8. And we will recite here 8 table. So 8 1s are 8, 8 2s are 16, 8 3s are 24, 8 4s are 32. So 4 is the answer. You know that, correct? Now here I will divide this 32 by 4. What we will get? Yes, you know. 4 8s are 32, isn't it? Now here, 4 multiplied by 8 means how much? 8 4s are 32. So, dear students, by one multiplication, we get 2 divisions. See here, this is only one multiplication, that is 8 multiplied by 4 is equal to 32. From this, we can get 2 divisions. Here 32 divided by 4 we did, then we got the answer 8. When we carried out 32 divided by 8, we got the answer 4, isn't it? So remember, we can get two divisions from one multiplication. We will go through some of the examples. See, dear students, one multiplication is there. 8 multiplied by 5 is equal to 40. 8 5 is 40, you know. One I will show you. Now, first I will write 40 divided by 8. Okay, one division. 40 divided by 8 is nothing but 5. Because 8 5 is 40, isn't it? Now, second division I will do here. 40 divided by 5. Second number I used. So 5 8s are 40. Got this answer, means by one multiplication I got two divisions. One and this is second one. Two divisions. First I used this number and second I used this number. Anyway you can do. First you can use this number also or this number also. The answer will remain same. One more example. 8 multiplied by 7 is equal to 56. 8 7s are 56. Yes. Yeah, 56 divided by 7. You can take any number first, okay? 7 8s are. So answer is 8. Here 56 divided by 8. Correct? The answer is 7. I think you understood this. Four sixes are 24. Again, here we can write 24 divided by 4 is equal to 6. The same three numbers repeat, but they change their order. Okay. And the operation. 24 divided by 6 is equal to 4. Next. Very easy it is, so I am going a little fast. 27 divided by 3 is equal to 9. Second one, 27 divided by 9 is equal to 3. Isn't it? Nine fives are 45. 45 divided by 9 is equal to 5. And 45 divided by 5 is equal to 9. Very easy. 4 sevens are 28, right? 28 divided by 7 is equal to 4. 28 divided by 4 is equal to 7. I hope you are enjoying, correct? Solve the following problems. See, there are 8 problems, that is of division. Sorry, 6 problems are there. You have to solve these problems. I'm not going to give you the answer. You have to verify the answer by making multiplication also and by making division also. I hope you understood each and every part of this lecture. That was very easy, isn't it? Okay, we will stop here and in the next lecture, we will again continue division. Thank you very much for being a part of this lesson. Please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon to get new updated videos.